Hello, good morning everyone. Today we are going to review the reversal setup and mainly answer a few questions that most people ask. The reversal is a setup composed by two things. First, we detect oversold and overbought bars, and then we have an entry technique. As you may already notice, we have two different signals, dots, which are the reversal bars, and arrows that are the result of the entry technique. The entry technique is called RBO, reversal breakout order. Let's see how this works and to try to understand how to adjust the settings so we can make it work on any time frame. On this example, we are looking at a Unirenco, and if we use the default settings, an oversold of 15 and an overbought of 18, then we don't get almost any signal. So to try to understand what we need to change, let's use a stochastic. This is a slow stochastic. The stochastic has two lines, the key and the D line, but we are only interested in the key line. The D line is an average of the key. So if we set a period of 1, both lines are overlapped. So now, as we have two overlapped lines, I will use the second line to plot dots so we can better identify which is the value of the stochastic for each bar. We have also overbought and oversold levels. And these are the default settings that we use on the reversal. On the reversal, we have the overbought and oversold levels and the key line period and the smoothing. The same settings that we have on the stochastic. The D line is, we are not using it, so we are using a period of 1. So we have an overlapped key and D lines. The rules to have a signal is that we need for a short signal, like on this bar, we need to have two stochastic points over the overbought level, and the second one must be below the other. So we have two consecutive stochastic dots, both over the overbought level, and the second one is at a lower level than the first one. On these two examples, the second point is below the overbought. Here we have another example. The second point is below the overbought, so we don't have signal. If we replace the thresholds and make them less tight, for example, the double 30 for the oversold and 70 for the overbought, now we have, for example, these two points. Are one the last one is lower from the other, and both are over the overbought level. So we have on this case we don't have signal. The second point is below the level. So if on reversal we change these threshold levels, now we get the reversal dots. We don't get this cell signal, but what we get is that this buy signal, because we have two consecutive dots below the oversold, and the last one is over the previous. So the rule to define the best settings to use are looking for the best thresholds to use so we get signals on our time frame and instrument. We can also sometimes change the period. I usually never do that, but we can even fine-tune the settings by changing the period of the key line and also the smoothing. We can see some differences, but not so much. In second place, we have the entry technique. For example, on this bar, we have a reversal signal. We don't have an RBO entry, but we have a reversal because we have two consecutive bars with a stochastic below the oversold and the last one is higher than the previous. Now, once we have a bar with a reversal signal, with a dot, then we can use the RBO entry technique. When we have the bar complete, then our RBO entry is a buy stop, a certain number of ticks, usually I use three ticks over the high of the signal bar. And this order remains active by a certain number of bars. I usually use three bars on the first, second and third bar. We don't get a fill, so the order is cancelled. So we don't get an arrow. On this example, we have arrows because if we place a buy stop, we get a fill on the following bar. Same on this other signal. This is the bar with the reversal signal, and we place a buy stop and we get a fill at the following bar. On this short signal, the sell stop located three ticks below never gets a fill. Then the order is cancelled and we don't get an RBO signal. Something also very interesting that this indicator, the reversal, does is showing information while the bar is painting, indicating if it is possible or not that we get a reversal bar. For example, on this case, I will go back to this cyan dot so we can see how it is signaled while the bar is painting. Now we can make the stochastic to update intra-bar. So this last stochastic point is refreshed tick by tick while the bar is painting. At this moment, the bar is not yet complete and we get a possible reversal because this point is higher than the previous. The stochastic is higher than the previous. It is also below the threshold. And we have an unconfirmed dot, an unconfirmed signal. We also get a horizontal line showing the possible RBO entry. Because the bar is not yet complete, the stochastic can move over or below the previous point, so the dot can appear or disappear. But we get an early warning that we may have a possible entry, so we can place or buy stop entry, keep adjusting to the place that it is indicated by the indicator, or cancel if the trade is cancelled. At some moment, when the bar is complete, the dot turns to cyan, to light cyan, as the previous one. That means that we have a confirmed dot and also a confirmed entry. This bar is not yet complete. We can place the entry order in advance, but I will show how to wait for the confirmed signal. At this moment we have a bar closed and the reversal was confirmed because we have two stochastic points of finished bars with an ascending slope, so we have a reversal dot confirmed and also a reversal entry price confirmed.
Order pending.
So we can place a buy stop on that value, three ticks over the high of the signal bar or the offset that we define on the settings, and this order will remain active for
order
the number
filled
of bar that we define. We can define the bar life on the indicator, so if at the following bar we don't get a fill, then the order should be cancelled. But as we can see, we get an arrow at the precise moment that the entry price was touched. I forgot to add target and stop, so I will cancel this position. So let's make a review. The reversal uses stochastic, a slow stochastic, to detect reversal bars. We only use the key line and we need two consecutive stochastic dots trending in opposite direction from the trend and over the overbought or below the oversold. When that happens, we get a dot. After we get a dot, we can use the RVO entry technique. RVO entry technique is the one that places these arrows, and it consists in placing a buy stop over the high of the signal bar plus an offset, or below the low of a short signal bar plus an offset. Okay, hope this video has been useful for you, and if you have any question, please post below this video. Thank you, bye bye.